Hello, Bigfoot. I brought some trap for you. I'm trying my best to find you a human sacrifice. I think I know the perfect person. I just need a little time.
Beautiful land creation.
Neal!
Tom McClellan, how the hell are you?
Oh, I'm fine. But Neal, listen.
I was gonna go to the Rib tonight and have a pint. How's about you come?
I assure you I'm fine, Neal. I've got some bad news.
The usual. Crystal Pepsi on the rocks.
Thank you, Jack.
Of course, Neal. if I may. Are you well? You look like the ghost of Tim Finnegan.
Listen, Jack. When I was younger, my mother used to tell me a story. It just came back to me today. It goes like this. There's a drove of hares in a field, and then they're playing or grazing or doing whatever it is hares do when nobody's watching. Except something was watching. A hungry red fox. And of course, this is at night. Foxes always hunt at night.
Twitch for Braden.
What's up, Twitch?
Hey, man, I'm gonna stay a little late and watch the hatchery. See why we've been missing so many trout here lately.
It's probably just a boat show or a meme. Get some sweet.
I can't. Something big afoot here, man. I'll see you in the morning for the kids' macaroni art demonstration. Over and out.
Fox patiently waited. He waited for one hare to unwittingly hop far enough away from the rest. So he sat still, behind a bush, skulking, until finally he had his victim, a young and healthy Jill, a very integral member of the drove. So he tensed his haunches, preparing to pounce. However, just before the fox attacked, all the other hares noticed him. So they all scattered away, fleeing for their lives. All except for one. And in an act of noble altruism, this one hare, old and crippled, leapt towards the fox, sacrificing his life. I'm going to Missouri, Jack.
What's waiting for you in Missouri?
The Red Fox.
Braden, you're a sight for sore eyes. Well, it's great to have you back in Cassville.
Well, I wish I were here under better circumstances, but I'm here nonetheless.
Well, how's the fishing?
It's good. Twitch has been stocking the place well.
Speaking of Twitch, how is the old rambling gambliner?
Waiting for Neal.
Yep. Neal here.
Bigfoot's
been spotted on camera too.
Where did you go?
Neal? Bigfoot just grabbed something
really pointy.
Neal, I've been here for 200 years. My body, my physical body, stuck here to serve Bigfoot. And only you can help me now. You'll find Twitchell near Hub Valley. He's the next sacrifice. Save him and set me free. Oh, and Neal, I must warn you. Once you kill Bigfoot's caretaker, you're going to become his next successor. The Fountain of Youth will call you. Kill the legendary Sasquatch and end this. For good. Twitchell, thank God, I thought I'd never find you.
Neal, we gotta get out of here. Quick, untie me.
How the hell are you still alive?
Alan has me here for some special ritual about sacred blood and eternal life. Get me out of here, he's almost back, man. Come on.
Eternal life?
Come on, Neal.
I can't. I need to end this.
Oh, come
for good.
On, dude. He deserves already got here. I'm just gonna go more. Come on.
It's your time, Twitch. If you're not a believer, I'll make you one. I need the blood of one anyway. It's been 2 months in the making. Your sacrifice will mean a great deal to me and Bigfoot.
What about Bigfoot?
To Bigfoot, all things good. Trout as well as eternal salvation came by Alan. And Alan came by damnation. I'll not be damned so easily.
Fountain of youth, Neal. This is where Alan's been wetting his whistle. The local watering hole for all Bigfoot servants. He's near. He's hiding from us.
Yes, Twitch. I've got a plan.
I'm ready, Bigfoot. I'm ready to serve you. I killed Alan, so that means I take his place, right?
I still find it hard to forgive myself for taking Alan's life that day, even though I had no choice. A sad misfortune came over him, and he was damned to serve the legendary Sasquatch. I have good reason to believe Twitchell and I slain Bigfoot at the Fountain of Youth, But if there's one thing I've learned, it's that hell hath no fury, like Cassville, Missouri.
Forget the size of his feet.